Lesson 25, differentiating between relations and functions. So let's go through some vocabulary words. First one is domain. Domain is just a set of possible values for the independent variable of a set of ordered pairs. So in other words, this is really dealing with your x-coordinate. This is your x-coordinate that they're referring to. A range is a set of values for the dependent variable of a set of ordered pairs. This is working with your y-coordinate. And then relations and functions. A relation is just a set of ordered pairs where each number in the domain is matched to one or more numbers in the range. So every ordered pair is a relation. A function is a mathematical relationship pairing each value in the domain with exactly one value in the range. So one x value can have only one y value. You can't have the same x value have two different y's. That cannot happen. That would not be a function. So one x value with exactly one y value. So let's take a look at some examples here. This first one here, we just want to determine the domain and range. So this top one, we have our set of ordered pairs here. And we want to identify what is our domain and what is our range. And we put them as a set of numbers. So the domain in this first one is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 8. It's just the first number in each of our ordered pairs. And you notice that 2 is mentioned twice, but we only put it once in our set. And then it makes it easier when you put them in from smallest to largest. You can check to see that you've included all of your numbers. And then the range. The range is always your y. So you can see that we put our y's in here. So it's just the second number in each pair. So it'd be 1, 6, 9, and 10. You notice that there are multiple sixes in there, but we only put it down once. So let's look at our domain here in this next the bottom set. So if we were to write all of our domain, we have a 1, we have a 2, we have a 3, we have a 4, we have a 7, and we have an 8. That would be our domain, or all of our x's. Our range, which is be our y's, we have a 1, we have a 2, we have 5, we have a 6, we got a 7, and we have a 10. So there we identified our domain and range. And sometimes you might see them rewritten as like a table with all your x's on one side and all your y's on the other. So your x's would be your domain and your range would be your y. Example 2, identify sets of ordered pairs as a function. So here we want to determine if it's a function or not. And remember, the domain only has one value in the range in a function. We want to determine, is this set a function? So I'm going to look to see if I have any x values that repeat. So I have a 3, a 10, 0, an 8, a 4, a 10. If I look at this one, 10, 1, and 10, 2, my domain is 10. But I have two different ranges, a 1 and a 2. Because there's, if I put a 10 in the equation, I can't get two different answers. I can't get a 1 one time and a 2 another if I put the same number in the same equation. So no, this is not a function because the domain has two values in the range when it can only have one value. Next one, determine whether y equals half x minus 1 represents a function. So you can see in my table below, I plugged in some numbers in for x to see if anything would change. If there's any domain that repeats, there isn't a domain that repeats. And if it does, if a domain does repeat and it has the same range, then it is still a function. So here, nothing repeats. So yes, this is a function. Next one, use a diagram to determine if the following set is a function. So I can draw, I'm just going to draw a box here. This will be my domain. I'm going to put all my x's in here, and I'll put them in order so I know I'm using all of them. So I got a 5. I got a 11. I have a 12. I have a 13 and a 14. And then over here, I'm going to use this as my range. So I have a 1. I have a 5. I have a 7. I have a 10. And I have a 12. And then I'm just going to match them up. So 5 is matched up with a 5 because it's the order pair right here. 11, so 11 and 12, so 11, 12. I have a 12, 1, so 12, 1 goes up here. I got a 13, 7, so 13 gets matched up with a 7, and 14 gets matched up with a 10. So if I look at my arrows, each domain is only pointing to exactly one range. And so, yes, this is a function. Determine whether the y equals 3x minus 1 represents a function. So I gave the domain, and the domain, you can put any numbers in for the domain, any for the x, to find your y. So if I put a negative 1 in, 3 times negative 1 is negative 3, minus 1 is a negative 4. 0 times 3 is 0, minus 1 is negative 1. 1 times 1 is 3, minus 1 is 2. 3 times 2 is 6, minus 1 is 5. 3 times 3 is 9, minus 1 is 8. 3 times 4 is 12, minus 1 is 11. Nothing repeats, so yes, this is a function. Next part, identify a graph as a function, and here we use the vertical line test. And the vertical line test is just drawing a vertical line and a hat. If it's a function, it only crosses the graph once. So in this first picture, the vertical line crosses the graph only once, so it's a function. Vertical line here crosses in one place, so it's a function. Vertical line here crosses in one place, so it's a function. Vertical line crosses in two places, here and here, so it's not a function. And the vertical line here crosses here and here, so that's why that's not a function. So let's work with those here. We're going to graph these ordered pairs and then determine if it's a function. So negative 6 and negative 4. Negative 6, negative 4 would be down here. 0 and negative 1 would be here. 2 and 0, 5 and 3 halves, so 5 and 3 halves is just 1 and a half, so that would be in the middle here, and then 7 and 5 halves, so 7 would be out here, 5 halves would be 2 and a half, so that would be up here. So if I were to draw my line here, and then I use the vertical line test. And I can use the lines on the graph on the coordinate plane. It only crosses in one place. So yes, this is a function. Next one, graph these ordered pairs. So negative 1 and 3. So negative 1, positive 3 is here. 0, 0 is here. 1 and 3 is here. Negative 2 and 6 is here, and 0 and 6 would be up here. So if I were to draw my graph here, it would go here, up and down. I'm just going to make this straight because it was straight up here. So now if I do a vertical line test, it crosses here, here it crosses the whole thing, but there's 2 points right on top of each other. If you ever see that, then it's not a function. So no, this is not a function. And next problem, write a function. So when you write in function notation, just know that y is the same as the function of x. So the independent variable, which is x, determines the dependent variable, which is your y. And y is a function of x. And so you can write it as y is the function of x. Y equals 6x plus 3 is in y equals mx plus b, or slope-intercept form. The same as if you were put that as a function, the function of x equals 6x plus 3. And so the variable that you have over here goes in the parentheses. So this f just means the function of the variable, or the function of the independent variable determines the dependent variable. So we want to write x plus 2, y equals 5 in function form. So I need to first make it into y equals mx plus b format. So I'm going to subtract x on both sides, and I get 2y equals a negative x plus 5. And we always want to put our x term first. Then I divide by 2. So now I have y equals a negative half x plus 5 halves. And to put it into function notation, instead of y, I'm just going to use the function of x equals half, negative half x plus 5 halves. And let's look at some other problems. Food labels list the grams of fat, carbohydrates, and proteins in a single serving. Proteins convert to 4 calories per gram. Write a rule in function notation to represent the number of calories from protein. So if I want to find out the number of calories from the protein, so the function of P would be our calories. So if I would take 4 times the number of our calories, or in this case it would be 4, our dependent variable would be the number of proteins that we have. The amount of protein, that will tell us how many calories we got from the protein. So 4, the function of P equals 4 times P. The second one, a brochure costs 7 cents per page to print. Write a rule in function notation to represent the cost of printing C copies of the brochure. And here I give the starting point, the function of C. And we just use C because they told they used C in the problem. So if it's 7 cents per page, which means per copy, it's going to be 0.07 times our C to find out what the total cost would be. And the last two problems. A student reads an average of 25 pages per day while reading a 544-page novel. Write a rule in function notation to find the number of pages she has left to read at the end of any given day. So, function of D. She's reading 544 pages. Whatever she has left, it's always going to be minus 25D. It's 25 pages per day. We want to know how many pages she has left. We're just going to say whatever number of days she's read for, multiply that by 25, we're going to subtract that from 544. So that would be our function. And the last one, an author writes 30 pages per day. Write a function that rule that the author can use to find out how many pages she has left to write before reaching page 400. So the function of D, so the number of days. So she's going to be writing 400 pages. We're going to subtract however many pages per day she has written. So 30 pages per day. So wherever the number of days would be, multiply that by 30, and then we subtract our answer from 400.